and Alex finally makes it back up towards Nova Scotia and other areas of Canada.
And we could finally put this thing to rest. My goodness. All right, but the impacts in the aftermath here, as you see here, across Florida, this is from Cedar Key, and look at the flooding issues there. Again, well away from the center, having to deal with that. Just a mess there across the west coast of Florida. Let's take you back to what we were dealing here with Hermine as we were seeing it here in the Gulf. Back to Wednesday, there it was, getting itself together and starting to finally get its act together here as we start to work our way into Thursday and Friday. Made that landfall late Thursday night into early Friday morning, and then worked its way up off of the southeast coast as well. But it certainly caused some issues, some of the big time totals here for rainfall. Lake Tarpon, that was the winner here, 22 inches plus. Several areas with double-digit rainfall totals, so it was quite a bit of a mess leading to some of the scenes like you saw there in Cedar Key. Now, things have settled down much more here for us across the state of Florida, returning more to our general sort of regime of showers and a few storms that fire up here for us during the afternoon hours. And that's what we'll see as we head on through today. Basically, from I-4 south, we'll be looking for that activity. And then as we head to tomorrow, and we see that again, south sections of Florida, we're seeing that chance for a few showers and storms.